Thank you for using the HECVAT. This video is for institutions to learn how to effectively evaluate a HECVAT received from a solution provider. In addition to this video, you can find written guidance on our website, educause.edu/HECVAT. When you receive a completed HECVAT from a solution provider, everything the institution needs can be found in the yellow tabs labeled Evaluation. Those include Institutional Evaluation, High Risk Evaluation, and Privacy Analyst Evaluation. In each of the evaluation tabs, information will pull from other locations in the worksheet and allow you to evaluate the solution provider's answers based on your own policies and appetite for risk. At the top, you'll find the information for the company and the name of the solution the HECVAT has been completed for. Below their information, you'll find a score report broken down by category. In column C of the score report, you will find a checkbox that allows you to include or exclude any category from the score. As an example, if a product that you are evaluating has the ability to process credit cards, the solution provider will have filled out the Payment Card Industry Data Security Standard, or PCI DSS, questions. If you won't be using that feature in their product, you can uncheck the box for PCI DSS so their answers don't impact the overall score. Below the score report, you can see all of their answers in one place and change if or how those questions impact their score. There are also a number of qualitative questions that must be evaluated in order to factor into the score. Starting with the company information section, you can see what the compliant response decided by the volunteers who have created these questions is. If the solution provider or answer matches the compliant response, the question positively impacts their score. If they don't match, their score is negatively impacted. If for any reason you disagree with the compliant response, you can use column G to mark the score as compliant or not compliant. If you change a compliant response to mark as non-compliant, it will then negatively impact their score, and vice versa if you select mark as compliant. Each question has also been assigned a default importance level. Critical importance questions have the biggest impact on score, while those assigned minor importance have the smallest impact on score. You can change the importance on any question using the dropdown in column I. Any question labeled critical importance will also automatically show in the high risk evaluation sheet. As an example, if you see line 64 and think that this question is more important to your institution, you can mark it as critical importance. Now it will more heavily impact the score and it will also show in the high risk evaluation. Lastly, column J is labeled non-negotiable. All questions with the non-negotiable box checked will show in the high-risk evaluation sheet. If you would like to do a cursory review of the solution, you can check the box in column J and see only those preliminary questions aggregated in high-risk evaluation. This allows you to do a smaller review of the solution for those questions that might be deal breakers before going on to fully review the tool.